Now the last time I went hunting in the valleys of your town, on my feet was sore and my throat was dry, the sun had just gone down. I rested off at the waterhole for a couple of cooling beers, and there caught a glimpse of the dreaded beast that every hunter fears. The cafe table forest, I watched her went away, and I marveled at her fluid race as she softly stalked her prey. Oh, a haughty glance to left and right and a ruffling of the hair, and then a sudden stillness and the tension in the air. There he sat, the poor young man, and the smile that he gave was real. He was so fresh and green, he'd no idea he was her evening meal. Oh, he blushed and stammered and he tried to speak, but he found that he was not able, as she dipped her claw in the blood-red wine and wrote yes, yes, yes on the table. Then she sat down next to him and stroked him with her eyes. Then she placed a velvet paw on his and flattered him with sighs. Oh, he hardly heard her throaty purr, and he missed its hidden warning. Oh, lend me your body for the night, you get the bones back in the morning. Stood and she lifted him, I carried him away, and we've not seen hide nor hair of him until this very day. So if you should go out in the evening in search of likely game, oh, you better watch out for the man-eater, or she'll get you just the same. Better watch out for the man-eater, or she'll get you just the same. Better watch out for the man-eater, or she'll get you just the same.